Hi, Gems. If you'd like to come on in and have a seat for some symbolic support, my name is Steph. I have created an inkblot, a little small scroll made in your name and essence that we are going to scribe from one direction for shapes and symbols that may speak to our psyche and psychic senses. As well, we'll add on Tarot and Oracle in the Shaman's Palm configuration. And where Mr. Ghost Gift is here kicking, we're utilizing Ghost Tube for any audio additions that may further inspire or irritate. Overall, pleased to receive a release freely. Gems, I am so grateful for your attention and awareness. I want to thank you so much for being here, for your like, share, subscribe, and support. I'm going to take a moment to open up. You are welcome to start scrying, commenting below, or keeping to oneself what you see, sense, and feel, as your perspective is powerful. Closing the eyes, cleansing the palate of perception, releasing the race in the rush. Activating the abstract mind and ancient awareness to perceive and receive symbolic support in the name and honor of Geminis. Gems, may you meet a message with meaning, and thank you for being my muse. All right, let's get at her. All right, I have some insights over here that we're stepping forward, so I'll start with those, and then you have these little oracle cards. Say little, love much, give everything and continue walking. Like, how adorable is that?
I want to.
I feel like, Gems, you might be doing something silently, and that's going to bring me into over here in a moment. And your secret language of light is alignment. You need alignment. Or looking at alignment. I feel like this is very much so like the above and below. And your heart, even if this is like mind and body, your heart is in the center space. Okay, let's dig into the scry. A scry on. So I saw sails up here, but they're like bat wings. And what, as I was getting ready for your reading, I noticed that they actually transformed on me. So I feel like I am on a bicycle that is flapping these wings, and I'm getting ready to take off. It's like utilizing boots to the mud work. Something feels like it's getting faster and faster and faster. And then all of a sudden I'm able to take flight. Something, maybe something in the mind, or having, even from like your alignment, the body and the mind with the heart space in the center. It's like, okay, I just heard the Care Bear countdown song come in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Interesting. I also saw over here, down here, if you want to take that in with me, there is, I'm seeing it like a Muppet. Yeah, it's kind of like a Muppet character. And their eyes are a little squinty. And it's like, come here. Come here. Come here. It's an interesting feeling. Like, I'll be honest with you. I don't know that I want to, because I'm not really sure.
Collar.
Why? Yeah, in regards to the collar thing, it's a good symbol because it kind of makes me feel like I'll be put on a leash. And Gems, I'm not getting the sensation that that's something that you're interested in. Oh. Okay. But he has like this, it has this vibe, sorry if that was weird, like, come here, come in a little closer, come in a little closer. And it's like, as I get closer and closer, and then I feel like, me as Steph, I feel like I'm going to be like snagged, you know, like, whoop. And maybe this, you know, like you're trying to get a dog or a pet or an animal just so you can put, and it doesn't have to be a leash or a collar on, but something along that lines where it just feels tracky. I don't know what, like it just, it feels something. I don't know. I'm going to leave that there. Leave that there. There's also carrots here off to the side. And radishes. Now they're changing on me to radishes. So I don't know if there's something about your food, or specifically the color red with the radish and orange with the carrots for like the sacral space, your root.
It's possible.
Root vegetables. Root vegetables. I don't... Okay, so I'll leave that there. You also have what I'm seeing is a wide stance. If these were eyes, these are arms where the carrots were, and these are feet. Yeah, see, there's something else growing here. Is it cabbage? Possibly. Maybe pumpkins. Pumpkins? Pumpkins. What's happening? Am I. It's like a pumpkin that I enjoy as a pumpkin. It's not just for pleasure of seeing a pumpkin like Halloween or something like that. I feel like there's a lot Geminis know, symbolically speaking, about said pumpkin. Is it can transform? Somehow it holds
You
magic.
won't understand.
Sometimes, yeah, I don't understand it all. So, somehow the symbol of pumpkin, and maybe it means something to you, holds magic. Right in about here, I am reaching out. I am, okay, so here's the fun thing. I am tethered to something. Sorry, that wasn't the one. I am tethered, not like when we were talking about the collar and the leash. But this feels like a harness. Yes, this is kind of could be in the heart area of a harness. So whatever your heart is powering, because I'm seeing it like it radiates out towards thing, like something might be oil engine, electric engine, solar powered. This is heart powered, and
I hear you.
I'm harnessed to something. So I can reach out, you know, like if you know you have a harness, then you can like reach, because you know you're good. But I'm reaching out for something. This could be somebody in that has passed that you are looking to reach out to, and you are extending yourself, not overextending yourself. This also could be a possibility of something that, again, in this heart thing, in your heart power. What I'm leaning closer towards. But it's almost like there's a physical expression of leaning forward. And I'm almost hearing like you can come back to like the tree, the trunk, the pole. And another way to go about it is focusing on the spiritual or energetic, whatever
Goodbye.
things that goodbye that you might be, could work on as well, so that it extends out, so the physical reach is less far. Okay, so I'm hearing it's harmonious. This is why you're doing it at the same time. There's something about building your character. Thank you. Something about the shape of your character, because there's all these shapes in here. Triangles, ovals are important as well. What is that that I'm seeing? My nose is getting so itchy in your read too. Okay, you know those. Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry that I'm all over the place. I believe they're Chinese, but forgive me if I'm wrong. And we've had so many of them over the years. They come in this little like treasure case, and it has like this wonderful silk anyway, and there's the two balls in there, and then but you can do that with it. And they make that clang like ting, ting. That's what it's like. Here's the fun part though. It's not, well, I don't know that it's fun because I don't really
Where
know
are
what it
you?
means. It's not doing this, it's this. And then I kind of go back into that eyes closed, like, come here. And then I'm brought into like the Matrix movie, that scene where he's like the red pill, blue pill, and it's like, pick one. This is a different context than the Muppet feel. That's like, come here. This is a choice. The other one's like a collar, and it, though I understand when I make the choice, I'm committed to it, that feels well. But there's something about I don't have all the information on the other side. I'm being lured. This feels like a conscious, intellectual choice, something I already know, something I have an inkling about, and I need to trust some part of it. There's also a
He
very,
told me.
very large energy around you that is, it feels mentory, confidant-y, you know, teacher, student, you can play. Maybe it's your shadow and your shine. It's like they're helping each other make decisions in that moment. Like if you could place yourself in the movie Matrix at that very moment, Neo is presented with it by Morpheus. Thank you.
Aquarius.
If you can plop yourself in his mind of how you would like go through the Rolodex of realities, of information, of this, that, or the other, that's the moment I'm in. And it's almost like that's where I'm running. And I come back up to the sailing bat wings, and then I take off. And then I glide. It's a gliding sensation. Some of you might be astral traveling a lot or having out-of-body experiences. Because there's a wide stance. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Piano down here where I wasn't sure what I was seeing before. I was getting a little constipated and I released it. So that's awesome.
I'm not sure how.
Have you ever seen I'm going to say old because I don't know what they look like new. It's a piano seat, I think, but that's how I'm seeing it. They're round. And on the bottom, they have glass ball feet. That's what I'm seeing. Something about not scratching the floors. It looks eloquent. These are windshield wipers. It's like I'm seeing a windshield, and these are windshield wipers, but they're my eyes. Your eyes, or the energy of your eyes, your ability to perceive and receive, whatever the case may be, is as large as like windshields on a car. Or a windshield, but of course I'm seeing it kind of in two because there's like the roof. Okay, that's fine. Those are your eyes of this car. Reaching out while holding on. Okay, we talked about that in the root space. Okay, in the piano seat. There's something about shaping the way you're shaping your character. That heart radiation of the love much, give everything, continue walking. Leave. It's as though the bottoms of your feet have like the bottoms of the piano seat things. Maybe you're putting crystals in your shoes or something along that lines. I'm not entirely sure, but that's okay. Okay. All right. Let's add on some tarot and then we'll take a look at your psychology card. Yeah. Taking flight. Cause that's what it feels like. I'm taking flight, but I'm sailing the skies. Like all this root boot work on the ground, gathering energy and momentum, but it's powered by the heart. Like that's the fuel, Gemini. That's the fuel. And then I can take off. Nine of Cups is in your cave of ice. Something about pure water, fresh water. Three of Cups in your cave of winds. And you know the drill. If these cards mean anything to you, please see, sense, and feel for yourself as I follow the art first. In your cave of hearth fires is Ace of Cups. Seven of Cups in your cave of rivers. And Two of Coins in your cave of earth. On the bottom, we have Four of Swords. Do you know what I kind of feel like? I feel like I'm a little bit of an inventor. Like I've been tucked away for a little bit.
Married.
And then a little birdie said something. A little birdie of my mind. he or she didn't have to say much, but it sparked something. It sparked something within me. It's like I somehow realized or... okay, hold on. It's like... gems. Okay. It's like out of the cave of ice that felt prehistoric, maybe perceptions, something might have been rebirthed by a conversation. Because it's like the 9 goes to the 3 goes to the 1. And while that may seem subtractive, yes, like subtracting. So there's also something about odd numbers with you, odd numbers, and then it all evens out. Odd numbers and it evens out. Something, it's like I'm inventing something that over time, maybe this is your character building. And you're starting to define something. The 9 becomes the 3 becomes the 1. And even in the 1, there's the 2 doves. And maybe this is some sort of peace. Give me a moment one more time. Because I'm seeing one of those hats that have like the little helicopter thing at the top. And you know, like when you're looking at a fountain and then there's some fountains with just like the one spout. And then every so often, or other kinds of fountains that they have more spouts. But then I want to come back
only
to
for you.
When I come back to the root vegetables, sprouts, something about my root. Give me a moment, Jem. Sorry, I'm working through it. You know, if you were younger, maybe even as an adult, doesn't have to be. There's no age there. And if you were going in a swimming pool and you might have had friends that would throw rings or coins, something at the bottom of the pool so that you could go and play and go like see how deep down you could go and how many can you grab at one time holding your breath. There's some space of unsurety. I'm back with Neo and what's his name? Morpheus. I'm back here and I'm like contemplating. There's a lot about this motion coming through in your read. Like this circular motion, the helicopter thing there, gliding and taking flight.
Stay with me.
And there it is there. There are those, the two, I think they're metal though. I could be wrong. You find them, you capture them, and you realize like they're tied together. Tethered, but not tied like a leash. Because I keep hearing the song Corn Freak on a Leash. And now I just like want to mosh pit it up. It's like your character can go. You can go to a country concert or classical concert and then also to a mosh pit. That's how that's making me feel. Okay, let's take a look at your psychology card and then the psychology dream card. So you know the drill. If anything is standing out to you, gems, look at that bullseye. Oh my goodness. The one. Okay. You look for a moment. Okay. I'm going to grab the card, which is number 14, if 14 means anything to you. I'm noticing the barn swallows are standing out, or at least I'm seeing them as barn swallows. There's a portion of you. Yeah, this feels personal. There's a portion of you that has passed on, but it's being resurrected in the 3. It's like Mother, Maiden, Crone, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
I can hear you.
This, that, or the other, whatever the case may be. Thank you. This is also the higher self, human self, and the heart self. The heart self. you're in alignment with the character building that you can, you know, you'll be able to hold and grow into. Focusing is the card here. The seeker shoots his arrows at the target. Key attitudes, concentration. What power brings our energies together when we feel most scattered? What power brings our energies together when we feel most scattered?
I can't.
We focus to bring ourselves in balance with the center out there as well as within. It's not the number of arrows you fire, but the spirit in which you let them go. We achieve mastery in a chosen arena by long practice, wailing out the forces of dissipation and distraction. Fight your demons, but see past them to a universe beyond. To focus, seek the center wherever it is meant to be, not where you aim for it. Your task, should you choose to accept, is to align your center with centers elsewhere as you move through your day. This is that
over here.
The heart thing. Did I share that I saw Care Bears? I can't remember, but I... 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There's the observatory. I think you're like space gliding. I swear to God, somebody's astral traveling, Gems. Like lucid dreaming, out of body. Shamanic journeying specifically as well just came through. I am seeing these leaves as those root vegetables, and I am, you can see there's like a magnifying glass looking at the leaves. When I go into your scroll, see if I can bring this up for you, and there's this carrot sideways, but there's like all this life on it. It's something about like the organics of it. Seeing the forest through the trees in your cave of rivers of how you're feeling. Sometimes Asylum. Something's overwhelming and I'm hearing, sit, pause. It's like have a meeting with all your minds. Your mind, your heart, etc. Have a meeting, discuss, breathe, talk to the trees, talk to the plants. Allow their energies to come in and help you. Because it's like something... excuse me, something more emotional, but it allows you to like play that pool game. Things have been dropped, seeds have been planted, and you can go retrieve them. Yeah, this is like shamanic stuff, but it's like the benefits of this alignment of above and below.
Slowly.
Do you know? Okay, sorry. Give me one moment. I apologize. I have like a frog in my throat. It's as though the shamanic journeying, the shamanic work, the inner work, call it what you will, apply any term that feels well to you. When you bring that up to the surface of the here and now, where the heart finds its targets, right, as you're navigating throughout your day, but it moves like water. And then in the sleep state, when you're, yeah. When you're in the sleep state, the work that you did or spent time in meditatively in the shamanic journeying enhances your astral travels, lucid dreaming. And then when you glide Tyler. Around, you get to look for spots. It's like another kind of emanation because now your heart's pressing down on the earth or like emanating down. And then from there, you get to decide what bullseye you would like to interact with from that space. Does this make sense? I hope so. It feels like it makes sense. It's that gliding feeling. But I was coming back down to your root vegetables, like coming back down and applying it in the human experience, in the heartfelt experience. Okay. Last but not least, let's add on some oracle cards from the Mega Deck. This is the Divination of the Ancients and Lightworkers Oracle Mixed. Initiation.
Undecided.
By Fire. Star Child. We'll take one more. Okay, we have a few more here. Oracle, we'll take them if they came out. Soul Child, Initiation by Air. We'll take one more. I gotta complete the pyramid. Yeah. On the bottom we have trust in the plan, because you're actually the plan maker, but it's like coming down from, there's all that space. You're receiving from your higher selves is what I'm simply going to say again. There's that emanation from the heart space, but it's meant to be on the land to emanate through for your experience. And even, it might even feel like this earthly experience sometimes is the initiation by fire, but it's a power. Master number also 22 might mean something to you or standing out to you. Star Child. Again, we're talking about like being very earthly and galactic-y, whatever that means to you, even just the space of it. And I apologize if there's ink in my nails. I do try to get it out, because it's like, this is the blend of these two. All this blue, the star systems, the fire on the pillars that ground you, your arms, something about your arms. Okay, it's dress. Like the ability to be in the mosh pit or at a classical concert. And then, you know, when they like do those mashups with, that's why, mashups and mosh pits. I love it. I got to write it down because I won't remember. Mashups and mosh pits. When they put the classical music for Christmas together with like rock and roll. It's got a whole vibe in and of itself. It's also bringing me into like Queen and other bands. For whatever reason, it's coming through in music that they do something different. Like they change music. They combine things. Like they combine things with precision, because you're inventing something. Some of you also might be like seeing coordinates. Some of you also might be remote viewers. Is this the gliding thing? Is this the remote viewers of the bullseye? Okay, gems. There might be a, well, because I'm seeing your twins or the essence of, but I see them as one, but I see them as one is sleeping in the, you know, in the human state of sorts. It holds the space. It holds the ground for the other aspect or the other energy to, you know, I can fly. That's what it feels like. You're very precise in what you're creating as a character for yourself. I mean, character building. I don't mean characters. You might interact with characters, interact with energy, people, places, or things. Again, I see like those bullseyes. What is gravitating for you? If it gets overwhelming, I stop and I just simply say, I don't even need to say it to anybody, because you say little, love much, and give everything, and you continue walking, but you pause. I can't say much here. I can't necessarily say what I'm doing. So I'm going to sit. If I can't yet see the forest through the trees, because inevitably you do, and you go up and you see the forest, when you come back down, it's a different landscape, right? A patch of grass can seem like a very little deal to us, you know, being 5 foot, whatever you are. But if you were in Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, that blade of grass is massive. Does that make sense? Nonetheless, whatever you are doing, congratulations, because you are precisely in alignment with the utmost integrity of what character building means to you as you're building your character here, because that is an expression of your heart, and that is known and felt. And if it's not received, or if anyone's trying to contain it, come here.
Betty.
No. All right. I want to thank you so, so much, Gems. I'm going to let you go. We will flip this another day in time for perspective possibilities. I am so grateful for you, if I haven't said so already. Like you guys truly shine like a diamond. Like you guys are just the diamond. That's how I'm going to say that. The gemstone, the crystal, the mineral, whatever the case may be, you guys are great. And I am so grateful for you. All the links are below to help a gal grow. And until next time, scry you later. So clever. Care Bear count, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's like the Care Bears and Korn getting together. Oh, that would be very fun. Very fun.